Hi.
Hello.
Ciao, welcome.
Hi, Richard.
How are you?
Nice to meet you.
Your date here.
Thank you.
Hi. How are you? I'm Nicole.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. Oh, I like your shirt.
Oh, thanks.
You
look lovely.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. This wasn't my original outfit choice.
It wasn't?
No, there was a fatality.
Call Judy.
Yeah, I was putting it on and it didn't want to be on me any longer. It kind of just...
Oh, so it wasn't actually a fatality? There wasn't a death in the family?
No. It was a death in my clothing.
Where are you from?
I was born in Africa.
Are you serious?
I was born in Zimbabwe.
That's cool.
Crazy, right? Yeah. First, I went to New Zealand before I got here. Oh. So I went to New Zealand when I was 14, and then I moved here when I was 25.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. So, yeah, when did you move to Australia?
Last year.
Last year?
Yeah.
Are you on a 2-year visa?
No. Oh. 4-year. I hope you're getting rid of me already. I find moving around a lot triggers the end of relationships.
Why are you currently single?
I don't know. I think it's weird because both my brothers married their first girlfriends. I've always been treated as the black sheep in the family. There's this view in my family of, well, why hasn't Richard met someone? Why is it taking him so long to find this girl to marry?
You've had girlfriends?
Yeah.
Just none serious ones, or?
Yeah. I've had a couple of serious ones in England, yeah. Longest was 6 years.
That's a long time.
Yeah.
Well, why did it end then?
I just broke down. Yeah. How about you? What's your longest relationship?
We were on and off for 10 years. Yeah.
That's impressive.
Yeah, but I mean, yeah, he never wanted to get married. Like, he was, he didn't believe in it. He didn't come from a family that had marriage, so he never saw marriage working. He's married now, though.
A year after we finally called it quits, he married somebody else. It was really very defining and such a crucial point. You kind of get to know who you are and what you're about. It was really sad.
Those few moments where she showed some vulnerability was very sweet. That sweetness, that just gets me in the heart. And now I'm looking to find the one. Well, they say opposites attract, and we're very much opposite. So it just depends if it's a compatible opposite or a incompatible opposite.
I think people just look at me and they just assume that I'm just, I don't know.
What?
Bitch. You don't think I look like a bitch?
No.
Mm-mm.
No. Why do you, is that how you like?
That's not like how I think people perceive me. I think that's how I come across.
Wait, does that bother you though?
Not really. Not at all.
Hmm.
What?
No, like, I don't know. I never know how I come across to people.
Quiet.
Quiet.
Shy.
What she said was, you don't talk a lot. What I heard was, you're not for me, this isn't working. I think I respond to how people are. So you're quite talkative, quite like, boom. So I'm like, all right, well, I'm just gonna like sit back here, let this happen.
And just watch her.
Whereas if you were really quiet, I'd probably like talk a little bit more.
I can't imagine you more talkative. I suppose if I shut the up, I'll find out.
No, don't just suddenly make it silent.
I found his energy really calming. I definitely thought he was getting more mature, which is nice.
Would you like to go on a second date?
I would like to see you again.
Yes, I would like to see you too.
Why are you shocked?
I didn't think you were into me.
So then why would you say that you'd want to see me again if you didn't think I was going to say that?
Good question, but I still would.
I'd like to see you again too.
Aw.
So don't cry, it's all right.
I'm not going to cry.
I think I kind of like your, like, I don't know, calmness. You're very, like, quite mellow. You're 40, but that's fine. We'll overlook it.
We're not 30s.
You're 40. As soon as you hit 37, you're 40. That's it.
Okay.
And when you're 40, you're 50.